New OpenAI artificial intelligence for Blender 3D modeling is 600 times faster than Google's. The next breakthrough to take the AI world by storm might be text-to-3D model generators that allow anyone to rapidly create their own virtual environments, regardless of their 3D design abilities. Imagine the power of being able to create a 3D model of any object for Blender by simply describing it in words. Point E from OpenAI is making this possible with its revolutionary text-to-3D mesh artificial intelligence. This new open-source AI project enables 3D modeling using text prompts, expanding the capabilities of its text-to-image software from two dimensions to three. This year, OpenAI has garnered significant attention for its DALL-E 2 text-to-image software, which, similar to Stable Diffusion and Midjourney, can create realistic or imaginative images from descriptive text. Point E utilizes a different machine learning model called Glide, which, when given a text directive, generates a low-resolution point cloud that resembles the input text prompt. Outputs from Point E haven't yet reached the same quality as a commercial 3D rendering in a film or video game, but this is not its intended purpose. Point clouds serve as an intermediate step. When input into a 3D application like Blender, they can be transformed into textured meshes with a more familiar 3D appearance. Although the method is not yet at the level of the current state of the art in terms of sample quality, it is much faster, taking 1 to 2 orders of magnitude less time to sample. This offers a practical compromise for certain applications. The main goal of Point E is to efficiently generate point clouds, and it's able to create 3D models in just 1 to 2 minutes of processing time, whereas state-of-the-art methods can take multiple GPU hours to complete a rendering. In fact, Point E is estimated to be about 600 times faster than Google's Dream Fusion text-to-3D model. While Point E is not yet a commercially viable project, it is a piece of foundational research that has the potential to eventually lead to rapid 3D modeling on demand. With further development, it may make it easier and more accessible for those without professional 3D graphic skills to create virtual worlds. Alternatively, it could potentially streamline the process of creating 3D printed objects, as Point E can generate point clouds suitable for use in product fabrication. There are potential risks and issues that need to be addressed with the use of Point E, including the possibility of creating blueprints for dangerous objects and the reliance on untested trust in the safety of the blueprints. Additionally, Point E is likely to contain biases inherited from its training dataset, similar to DALL-E 2. Point E's dataset, which includes several million 3D models and associated metadata of unknown origin, lacks any assurances that the source models were obtained with permission or in accordance with relevant licensing terms, which could potentially cause legal difficulties. The AI community's tendency to train machine learning models using the work of others without obtaining explicit permission has already resulted in a claim of copyright infringement against GitHub Copilot, a service that suggests programming code to developers using OpenAI's Codex model. There is a risk that texted image models may face similar legal challenges as they become commercialized. In conclusion, Point E from OpenAI has the potential to revolutionize the field of graphics and 3D printing by efficiently generating 3D point cloud models from text prompts. Breakthrough synthetic skin. A new haptic interface system called WeTac has been developed by researchers at the City University of Hong Kong that could potentially be used in combination with artificial intelligence and telerobotics. The group of researchers have developed this wireless haptic interface called WeTac that can be worn on the hand to provide a realistic touch experience in virtual reality environments. WeTac is designed to be soft, ultra-thin, and able to collect personalized tactile data to enhance the virtual experience through touch. While haptic technology, which allows for the sense of touch to be replicated in virtual environments, is a growing area of research, current haptic devices tend to be bulky and require wires. WeTac represents a significant advancement in this field due to its lightweight and wireless design. The WeTac system has a wide range of potential applications in fields such as gaming, sports and skills training, social activities, and remote robotic controls. It is believed that touch feedback, along with visual and auditory information, can greatly enhance virtual reality experiences. The researchers worked to create a haptic interface that was thin, soft, compact, and wireless so that it could be easily worn on the hand like a second skin, and their work was published in the journal Nature Machine Intelligence. Traditional haptic gloves often use cumbersome pumps and air ducts that are connected by cords and cables, which greatly detract from the immersive experience in virtual and augmented reality. The WeTac system consists of two parts, a small, soft control panel attached to the forearm called a mini soft driver unit, and a thin hydrogel-based hand patch with electrodes on the palm, serving as a haptic interface. The mini soft driver unit is lightweight, weighing only 19.2 grams, and measures 50 by 50 by 2.1 millimeters, making it small enough to be worn on the arm. It uses Bluetooth low-energy wireless communication and a small rechargeable lithium-ion battery. The hand patch is also extremely thin, ranging from 220 microns to 1 millimeter, and has electrodes on the palm. It is highly flexible and provides effective feedback in various poses and gestures. The WeTac system has been designed to allow users to easily find the optimal current level for each part of their hand. This personalized data allows the system to deliver electrotactile feedback to any part of the hand with the right intensity to avoid causing pain or going unnoticed. As a result, virtual tactile information, including spatial and temporal sequences, can be accurately reproduced across the entire hand. The WeTac system is designed to be worn on the hands and provides programmable spatial and temporal feedback patterns through the use of 32 electrotactile stimulation pixels on the palm. The average distance between the electrodes is about 13 millimeters, giving comprehensive coverage over the entire hand. To ensure safety, the device has several built-in safety features to prevent electric shock, and the temperature is kept within a relatively low range to avoid causing thermal discomfort during extended use. The WeTac system has been successfully used in both virtual and augmented reality environments and can be connected to robotic hands via Bluetooth. Its compact size, wireless capabilities, and emphasis on sensitivity make it easy for users to experience touch feedback through the device. Users of WeTac can feel virtual objects as if they are real in a variety of scenarios, including practicing sports with a virtual tennis ball, feeling a virtual cactus, or experiencing a mouse running across their hand in social events or virtual games. By the way, did you know deep learning AI engineers make an average salary of $144,000 per year with bonuses and benefits, all while working remotely? You could start learning for free today from world-famous deep learning AI researcher Andrew Ng, the co-founder of Google Brain, to work as a machine learning engineer from home. So get started for free today on Coursera.org with the link below to earn your deep learning AI specialization online at your own pace. And join the AI industry where there is a massive shortage of talent that companies are battling for to hire. Click now and transform your income potential with the power of artificial intelligence.